second, first, third division of the illustrious, renowned, and prestigious organization known as the Tinfoil Hat Society, or TFHS for short, whose goal is to protect the various sentient beings and even non-sentient beings from the various nefarious organizations that exist all throughout the known multiverse, including the multiverse itself, who we believe is the biggest nefarious organization in existence. Wait, doesn't existence reside within the multiverse? I need to look into that. Anyway, in just a moment, I will be conducting a 100 question questionnaire for the first quarter of this year. That's right, there will be, hopefully, 4 questionnaires this year, 1 in each quarter. And this is our way of making up for lost time. As we know, many members and potential new recruits have been looking to join the TFHS or renew their memberships and haven't been able to do so because of my absence. So I'd like to apologize. I've been busy establishing many TFHS outposts all throughout the aforementioned known multiverse, not just to keep track and keep an eye on the multiverse itself, but as well as many of its agents, such as the various stars, meteors, and planets. In any case, should you be successful in answering these questions, not only will you receive your official Tinfoil Hat Society membership card, which this year will give you a 0.01% discount at the Nothing store. Okay. Of course, you will also, most importantly, receive upon membership and induction into our fine, prestigious organization, your 1-year supply of officially sanctioned tinfoil. Now, in years past, the TFHS would design and come up with the questions for the annual questionnaire, membership questionnaire, but as I previously mentioned, because I was unavailable and many of us were quite busy, I know you don't really get to see anyone else besides me, but well, there's a reason for that. Anyway, because of my and certain other high-ranking members' unavailability to create the annual questionnaire, we left the design of the questionnaire up to our members, as they are very smart and aware of all the goings-on of the TFHS, and they are our ears and eyes on the ground, okay? And it's also our way of making up for lost time. All right, so, well, without any further delay, let's get to it, because we have, like I said, about 100 questions for this first quarterly questionnaire. Hopefully we can get through most of them. And this This will not only determine your eligibility into joining our prestigious organization, but also determining whether or not you are a member of a nefarious organization yourself. All right, so why don't you make yourself comfortable if you already haven't done so. We'll get started. First question by Agent Tamara Smelling. Does glitter have any effect on a tinfoil hat's effectiveness? Okay. Agent Antonov AN-12 asks, would you be able to distinguish tinfoil from saran wrap? Have any nefarious organizations reached out to you about your car's extended warranty, assuming you own a car? Okay. Agent Blue Penguin asks, have you or a loved one been in contact with any breathing entities in the last 72 hours? Okay. What's that? It looks like I am writing the answers down in the same spot. Well, you would be correct. I do that as to cover all of the answers, and then we have our own way of being able to read and decrypt the scribbles. So don't worry about it. Okay, Agent Montgomery Heiser asks, very few members of the DFHS sleep without their tinfoil hat, tinfoil blanket, tinfoil pillow, and tinfoil teddy bear. What else could you bring into bed for more protection? A, tinfoil phone. B, tinfoil fan. C, tinfoil socks. And D, tinfoil redacted. What will your answer be? Okay. Agent Nikyukuro asks, do you think it is possible to digest smaller parts of tinfoil over a long time to create a natural immunity to, what's this word, psychic or other outside influences? Okay. Agent Comedic Idiot asks, what are your thoughts on tinfoil turtles? Okay. I see. Next question. Agent Drew Thompson asks, how can I reach out and locate other DFHS members at my college campus? Okay. Agent Julian Strauss asks, how does the DFHS deal with the nefarious microwave and refrigerator issue that is currently going on in the Third Rift? Okay. Jason Nandu asks, Cthulhu is secretly conspiring with the entity to infiltrate and destroy the NWO. A. True. B. False. D. That information is classified. Okay. Next question by Agent Malty Nielsen. Do you believe in supernatural, seraphic, occult beings that are by default designed to spy on the DFHS, seek to destroy the platform on which the DFHS operate, and replace every single member with robotic creatures that are programmed to cooperate with nefarious organizations such as the government, whose goal obviously is to destroy the planet and all human beings? Agent Fans 00 asks, from which plant, if any, does the highly sought after tinfoil fruits come from, and in which country, planet, or universe do they grow? Okay. Next question by Agent Zach Museum. This is a multi-part question. Does the light from your smart TV or cell phone bother you or cause hallucinations? Do you feel even the light bulbs and lamps could be listening to you? Do you ever suspect one of your neighbors could be a spy for the nefarious organization? Are you taking two or more pharmaceuticals to deal with the modern world? Would you consider yourself a renegade or different from most people? If you answered yes to two or more questions, would you consider working for DFHS to collect information using questionnaires? Okay. Agent Princess Shinekchen asks, do you fold or roll your toilet paper? Okay. Agent Leo Morales asks, we have observed red strings which emit nefarious psionic waves stretching out for miles in vert. What's that? Oh, the P is silent, so it's psionic. Okay. Nefarious psionic waves stretching out for miles in various locations across the world. As such, every member of the DFHS must contribute to limiting their influence in some way. Would you be interested in A. measuring out thin strips of tinfoil, B. cutting thin strips of tinfoil, C. attaching thin strips of tinfoil to duct tape, D. covering miles worth of red string with duct tape lined with thin strips of tinfoil, or E, all of the above? Okay. Agent Nate Guy asks, what would you do if the world were to run out of tinfoil completely? Okay. Agent Young Body Old Mind asks, if you were to shop for the nothing tinfoil in the nothing shop, on what aisle can you find it? Okay. a nefarious organization who intends to pose as a Tinfoil Hat Society member and post questions for our next questionnaire in order to infiltrate our ranks. No, you would never do such an unethical thing. Okay, that's good to know. Agent Caldeo asks, quote, tinfoil is superior to all other materials. Discuss what this means to you and how tinfoil has helped you grow as a member of the DFHS and a person slash being slash entity slash object slash void. Or if you're not a member, as a potential new member. Okay. Agent Whale Ambassador asks, where were you in the War of 1812 when the Great Tinfoil Revolution was provoked under the Atlantic in an attempt to seize control of the Squid Warrior population? Okay. Agent Machine Gun Nasty asks, if you were presented with the opportunity of encasing your brain in tinfoil, would you accept? Okay. Agent Prophetic Marine asks, Joe leaves London at 12 p.m. carrying 4 kilograms of aluminum foil on a train going 70 miles per hour. David departs from Edinburgh by car, hauling 7 kilograms of tinfoil, and leaves at 1:15 p.m. When is the soonest point they will both pass the ERU multiversal nexus point, and how much tinfoil will they have on their person at that time? And you must show your workings and how you arrived at that answer. But you can tell me, of course. Okay. What's that? No, that's fine. I don't mind you asking about my eye. There's nothing wrong with it. I can see out of it just fine. My other eye? Oh, you mean the one that's was in my other eye socket that's now covered up with tinfoil? Yeah, I lost it. I don't know where it is, so until I can find it, it's kind of not too pleasant, you know, for other people to look into an empty eye socket, so I thought it's best to cover it up. Plus, it protects my eye socket from any nefarious rays, beams going right into my brain. Agent Matthew Graham asks, if you were starving and had no choice but to cook your rations in your tinfoil hat, would you potentially expose yourself to brainwashing waves long enough for your chicken tendies to warm up? Okay. Agent Nathan Palmer asks, how are you feeling? A, as protective as a tinfoil hat. B, as nefarious as a member of fish lump sop chicken nugget. D. Fine. E. Prepared to destroy all enemies of the Tinfoil Hat Society at the cost of my life, solely for the glory and greater good of the TFHS. Okay. Agent I-3145 asks, which of the following is true about the TFHS? A. Tin is greater than aluminum. B. Tin is greater than aluminum. C. Tin is greater than aluminum. D. Tin is greater than aluminum. E. Tin is greater than aluminum. That's a tough question, isn't it, Mia? Take your time. What will your answer be? A, B, C, D, or E? Okay. Agent Daniel Ferrer asks, do you support the decision to include radio trackers in your tinfoil helmet for better monitoring against nefarious imposters in our ranks? Okay. Agent Chasman258 asks, we are often told to behave, but what is have, and how can we be it? Okay. Agent Random Stranger asks, can an aluminum hat be used as a replacement for a tinfoil hat? A. Yes. B. No. C. No, and should be punishable by life and afterlife in a very damp prison located 3 light-years away, right next to a nothing store, hypothetically. A, B, or C? Okay. Agent Matt Chilton asks, what key secrets are there to the hierarchy of the TFHS, and what are the secret passwords? For documentation purposes, no less. Okay. Agent Jess GW asks, how much are you prepared to contribute in terms of money, time, snacks, or tinfoil to the TFHS? All of it. Okay. Agent It's Lara Man asks, if you hypothetically could take over the world using tinfoil, what brand would you recommend? Good choice. Agent Generic Kitty 50 asks, would you be willing to test the new tinfoil power armor? Okay. Agent Dr. Bob asks, is there a nefarious tinfoil hat society? Agent Jordan Greenwade asks, are you able to reach and or infiltrate Arkham Sanitarium if the society asked you to. Okay. Agent Zero Cost asks, have you ever partaken in the trafficking of aluminum foil for any nefarious organization? Asks, is there tinfoil in the depths of the void? If so, can you extract it? No, it doesn't state which particular void, but assuming any void that would contain tinfoil in its depths, would you be able to extract it? Looking to infiltrate our organization, what would the name of said hypothetical organization be? Agent Bored Will asks, when applying a protective layer of tinfoil to your home's walls, do you place this layer, A, before the drywall, B, between the drywall and depleted uranium, C, between the depleted uranium and Faraday cage, or D, if you are resorting to these measures, the lizard people already have you mind controlled? Okay. Agent Katie Boyce asks, would a lightning storm deter you from wearing your tinfoil hat in public? Okay. Agent Trey Saber asks, the first organization to pioneer mind control was A, the chimpanzees, B, the Egyptians, C, the Romans, D, the National Hockey League, or E, I am a spy secretly trying to infiltrate the Tinfoil Hat Society, and I have decided I want to come clean. Okay. Agent Nathan Owsey asks, would you recommend covering the entirety of Arkham Sanitarium with tinfoil to keep it protected from nefarious influences, or should the rest of the world be covered in tinfoil to protect it from the sanitarium's influence? Okay. asks, what are the precise measurements of your crunkles? Please state them in one of these units: inches, feet, yards, miles, kilometers, meters, decimeters, centimeters, millimeters, angstroms, Bohr radii, ASMRs, Arkham Sanitary Measurement Relay-ins, nothing units, grains of experimental sand, void particles, or the mysterious units of measured displayed on Professor Clemens' cutting mat. Asks, in the event that one must craft their own tinfoil hat, is the shape of the hat of critical importance? For example, for one of particularly linear, square, or cubic head shape, is it wrong to deviate from the standard cone-like shape? Hassan Malik asks, if a member of a nefarious organization managed to sneak a nefarious question into a TFHS annual or quarterly questionnaire, would you answer it? Thank you. Agent Eden L. asks, does your house have a tinfoil hat? Agent Lee Lee asks, have you ever considered placing your tinfoil wrapped leftovers on your head and placing your tinfoil hat on top of them so you can always have your lunch nearby? Agent George Kidashley asks, how much tinfoil is needed to disrupt telecommunications systems at Arkham Sanitarium? Agent Morgan Prescott asks, do you believe nothing foil hats purchased from the Nothing store are effective against nefarious mind control technology? Okay. Agent the Salty Sponge asks, if the New World Order came knocking on your door and asked you to reveal the identities of your fellow TFHS members or face execution, what would you do? A. Reveal their identities without a second thought. B. Say nothing, even though doing so will get you publicly executed. C. Attempt to bargain for your life by offering up your services as an informant for the NWO. D. Take out your TFHS-approved tinfoil pistol and attempt to fight your way out. E. Reveal that you are actually not a member of the TFHS, but rather a member of the Corrugated Cardboard Confederacy, and thus should join forces to take down the TFHS once and for all. Or F. That information is strictly classified. Okay. Agent Top asks, if there was only one tinfoil hat's worth of tinfoil left, would you use it on yourself or another? If another, who would that person be? Okay. Agent Michael Rigo asks, which of the following nefarious organizations best completes the analogy below? High fructose corn syrup infused breakfast wafers are to bovine mammary fluids as cranial dissection with intent to manipulate the psionic capabilities of future generations of TFHS members is to A. The Illuminati, B. The Kellogg's Corporation, C. Santa Claus and his elves, D. The Romanian Olympic Gymnastics Team, or E. None of the above. Okay. Agent Exterminator 2 asks, in the event of the Sun becoming an Apollyon class anomalous entity in which any organic material touched by the Sun's rays liquefies into a grayish goo, would you be willing to spill the secrets of the TFHS in exchange for your own survival? Okay. Agent Fauna Gaming asks, do you believe that there should be a limit to how many tinfoil hats you can make in a day? Okay. Agent AR asks, after having served multiple tours of duty for the TFHS, and having many years of experience, would you be willing to subject yourself to becoming a Tin Man in order to join the subgroup known as the Tinfoil Hat Society's Tin Men? I'm not sure if you are familiar with the exploits of the very first Tinfoil Hat Society Tin Man, who actually infiltrated the, I believe it was called the Emerald City. It was an, along with other members known as Dorothy and the Cowardly Lion and the Scarecrow. They are also TFHS operatives, but the Tin Man was the lead on that operation, and their goal was to infiltrate the Emerald City and take down the leader known as the Great Oz. And so, every so often, a member of the TFHS is able, has a choice after serving many years and becoming a tin man or tin person, however you like to say it, tin woman, etc., tin cat, tin box, fusing your own existence with the tin. Would that be something you might be willing to consider, should it be made available to you? Okay. An anonymous agent asks, is it okay to use tinfoil to grill your shelf? Okay. Agent Dario Burgess asks, have you ever been under the tutelage of Thomas T. Tensacular, and if so, was his tinfoil hat in the shape of a tasteful tricorn or a tempestuous turtle? Okay. Agent Lyndon Maman asks, what is the difference between tinfoil and aluminum foil? Okay. Agent Extroventurus asks, what is our protocol if members of any nefarious organization, including but not limited to the Parents, Aluminum Knotty, Daleks, Corrugated Cardboard Confederacy, the Teachers, the Freemasons, or the Leather Legion, manage to infiltrate our inner sanctum and stage a coup d'etat in order to topple our society from the inside, thereby rendering us scattered and lost without our carefully selected group of individuals? Okay. You were not aware that such a protocol exists. Okay. Agent Maria Estrada asks, will you be participating in the celebration of the alignment of the tinospheres? It only happens once every 54 decades, and our benevolent overlords would be very disappointed if such an esteemed guest as yourself were to miss it. I heard this time they plan to release the giant foil loons into the stratosphere, where all TFHS members will be able to receive the tingle signals. Such a delight. You will be participating. You wouldn't miss it. Neither would I. Agent Golden Memory Freeze asks, do you think that the various offspring of Dr. Corvus form a secret organization planning to overtake the Arkham Sanitarium cafeteria? Okay. Agent Curbed Magenta Gazelle asks, if a lizard person is wearing a tinfoil hat, do you accept them as a member or report them for being a lizard person? Agent Shabadoobie asks, should you be accepted into the DFHS, but actually be a spy for one of the various nefarious organizations? Would you be willing to come clean and divulge any secrets you have? A. Yes. B. No. C. I am not at liberty to say, as that would jeopardize my chances of being captured. D. Refuse to comment. Agent Peanut Butter Jelly asks, if your pets refuse to wear their tinfoil hats, are you willing to report their suspicious behavior to DFHS for investigation? Okay. Agent Sly the Great Nail Sage asks, are there plans to construct a tinfoil-topia? Okay. Agent Drew asks, if you happened to be a member of one of the many nefarious organizations of our time, which obviously you are not, because that would simply be impossible, and you went up to this stairway to my left through the double doors, took a right, and after door number 579 opened a door number 581 with the code 80085, slipped past our security guards, and were somehow miraculously able to acquire our most prized possession, well, one of our most prized possessions, the tinfoil chicken finger, what would you hypothetically do with it? This is a purely theoretical question, as no nefarious beings would ever pass this questionnaire. I see. Agent Busty Patches asks, did you submit anything to this questionnaire at the behest of a nefarious organization? Okay. No, absolutely not. You would never do such an unethical thing. Agent Timothy Tinfoil Tim Timmerman asks, what does behest mean? Asking for a friend. Okay. Oh, so that's what that means. Okay. I mean, the friend will be, pleased to know what that means. Agent Max asks, as a member of the DFHS, are you willing to accompany expeditions into unexplored rifts so as to report back on their destination and its value, allowing it to be exploited by the DFHS in its ongoing efforts against nefarious organizations? Okay. Thank you. random Xbox asks, is it okay to use the same foil I used for cooking as a radio antenna? Stetson asks, if someone asks you about your tinfoil hat, do you A, tell them about the TFHS and its mission, B, pretend to be mentally unstable to throw them off your trail, C, call the police, D, ask to see their official TFHS official membership card before further discussing the ever-present threat to humanity by the Masons, corporations, and other nefarious organizations over milk and cookies in a TFHS-approved secure location. Okay. Agent Jacob Pierce asks, if your mother and the TFHS were both dangling off a cliff, and you could only save one, who would you pick? The TFHS, obviously. Okay. Agent Skaterboy76 asks, if via means of interdimensional communication and psychic abilities, you learned that a close friend of yours was part of a nefarious group or organization in an alternate reality, would you be willing to turn them into the TFHS for their transgressions, even though it was a version of them they could not control? And if you saw yourself in one of these nefarious groups in this alternate reality, would you report yourself? Okay. Agent Phoebe the Brakeson asks, have you ever consumed any fur-covered tinfoil? Agent That One Sentient Bagel asks, if you were ever taken in by a nefarious organization, what is the correct procedure? A, tell them everything. B, try to escape. C, pose as one of their undercover operatives sent in to survey and examine the TFHS in order to find and destroy their stash of tinfoil. D, secretly bite on your standard issue foil-wrapped tooth, sending a shock into your body, killing you instantly. We cannot let them find out about Operation Crossbones. Okay. Agent Jessica Cook asks, what is your most favorite thing about tinfoil? Tracy asks, how many layers of tinfoil is necessary for maximum cranial protection from nefarious psionic attacks? Okay. Agent Gab Frab asks, are you or are you not in favor of using microwaves as a form of punishment? Okay. Agent Styx asks, would you be willing to interrogate your non-TFHS DHS relatives in order to collect data about their possible involvement with nefarious organizations. You would, absolutely. Okay. Agent Damon of Error asks, would you consider joining the DFHS's spring musical production called Tinfoil in the Time of Love and the Apocalypse? You would absolutely love to. Okay. Okay, we are down to the final set of questions. Agent Father Counts asks, would you consider sacrificing another member of the Tinfoil Hat Society for your own safety? Yes, absolutely. Okay. Agent Heather Love asks, trading hats with other individuals, stealing the DFHS signature designs, and the construction of a fake unbranded hat are all considered fraudulent actions. Yes or yes? Okay. Agent Ham Snadwich asks, do you believe the moon is made of tinfoil? Okay. Agent Solar Mod asks, would you ever consider using any material aside from tinfoil to create anything at all? No, absolutely not. Okay. You would never do such an unethical thing. Agent Tracy Iseb asks, can tinfoil hats also double as cones of silence? Okay. Agent Nick L. asks, what is the first role of the DFHS? Okay. Right. Agent Butter Toasties asks, have you ever interacted with a potentially nefarious being referred to as the Entity? Agent Butter Toasties thinks the Entity is nefarious, but we have yet to capture it or even attempt to perform a complete analysis of it. What is your answer to that? Okay. You believe we should capture it first and then perform some tests on it, subject it to various experiments before reaching a conclusion. Okay. Agent Send Cat Girls asks, do you think using wheat bread over white bread would be a good change for the DFHS? Organization, does it trigger your fight, flight, or plasma response? Okay. should say, new recruit, Dipolar Island asks, what is a good way to integrate the TFHS into my life? Not sure if you're aware, but with my one good eye, I was implanted. A small device was implanted into this eye. I'm able to decipher the scribblings of your answers. Okay. Well, at this time, I'd like to say congratulations. You are now an official member, or you have your membership renewed of the Tinfoil Hat Society. Here's your card, along with that discount on the back, all right? All the various numerous missions available to you, and maybe one of these days we'll go over the various missions available, okay? And remember, this is the first quarterly questionnaire. We decided to do it each quarter this year, so there are three more to go. And the event that anyone was unable, not only miss this particular questionnaire session, but there are other questions, very good questions posed by our other agents that we will need to ask in future questionnaire sessions, okay? So it was nice to see you again. Apologies this took so long, but hope to see you next quarter. All right, I need to, let me go now. I need to prepare for the next questionnaire. Next potential member, or existing member, I should say. All right, so take care, and so long for now, and stay safe, and stay protected, stay alert, stay awake, stay staying. Alright, so who's next?